@HamiltonCountyIN.com. And I want to welcome you to our first post of Reading Cafe. I will be one of your hosts. Our goal with Reading Cafe is to make sure you know what fun events the libraries in the county are hosting, and for you to find out about some great books to read from our local book reviewers. Let's start off and ask the children librarians to tell us about the events they will be having next week.
Hi, I'm Melissa, and I'm here at the Noblesville branch of the Hamilton East Public Library, and we're located at One Library Plaza in Noblesville. On October 18th, we have a Where the Wild Things Are party at 7 p.m. On October 19th, we have our annual Octoboo party starting at 7 p.m.
Hi, I'm Steve Martin. I'm the director here at the Sheridan Public Library. And we are planning a big Halloween program here on Saturday, October 30th. We're going to have games for younger children in our community room. And we were busy this afternoon over here with the staff. We're planning a Minute to Win It series of games for the older kids this year. And then we're going to have a storyteller, Mr. Bob Sander from Indianapolis, is going to come on that evening and do scary stories for us here. So we have a big event planned here for the 30th of October, the day before Halloween. We wanted to keep it on Saturday night this year so that the kids would be able to stay up a little bit later and not have to worry about going to school the next day. So we hope you'll come and enjoy our program and have a good time with us. We'd like to have everybody in the community and all across the county, really, to come and celebrate with us this year.
I'm Vicki Parker, and I'm the head of the Children's Department at the Westfield Washington Public Library. We have our fall activities brochure out. You can look online and get all this information, too, on our website. We have things for all ages of kids. You see, there's lots of stuff. We have clubs. Clubs meet usually once a month. They're free, and you don't have to register. You can just show up. We have a Webkinz Club, the first Thursday of every month, a Yu-Gi-Oh! And Pokemon Club, the second Wednesday of every month at 6:30, and the Webkinz is at 4:30. We have an American Girls Club, the second Thursday of each month at 5:30. Digital Treehouse is a new thing that we're trying out for kids to use online games and blogs and social networking and database and freeware and all kinds of things like that. And I'm sure we'll learn as much from the kids as they'll learn from us. And it is through up to adults. Our events are not limited to just Westfield residents. Anyone is welcome to come. We have many homeschool classes and things, and we have people from this region who come for those sometimes.
Hi, my name is Melissa Dragu, and I'm a Youth Services Librarian at the Fishers Branch of the Hamilton East Public Library. In the month of October, we have a few special programs coming up. We have our Halloween party, known as Octoboo, coming up on October 19th, that's a Tuesday, at 7 p.m. On October 20th, we have our Where the Wild Things Are party at 7 p.m. That's a Wednesday. And on October 25th, we have a special early literacy workshop for parents. That is for parents only, and it's a Monday at 7 p.m. And it's a program to teach parents special skills that can help their child learn to read, but it is not teaching children to read.
There's a lot of fun events next week, so please mark your calendars. Now let's find out about some great books that you can check out this weekend from our local reviewers.
My favorite book in the library is Mike Mulligan and His Steam Shovel, written by Virginia Burton. It's about a man named Mike Mulligan and his steam shovel. They dig canals, highways, and basements. Soon the gasoline, diesel, and electric shovels come in, and no one wants the steam shovels anymore. Then Mike Mulligan hears that there's a new town that needs a town hall with a basement. So they go over and ask the boss man if they can do it. And Mike Mulligan says, we can do it in one day. And the boss man says, impossible, because 100 men could dig that in a whole week. And then Mike Morgan says, if we can't do it in a year, if we can't do it in a day, then you don't have to pay us. So while they're working, a boy comes over and asks if he can watch, and Mike Morgan says yes. So he starts watching, and bunches of people start coming, and they start working faster and faster and harder and harder. And then as soon as the sun is setting over the hills, everything goes quiet, and once the dust cloud clears up, they see four corners and four perfect straight walls. But everyone starts arguing because they don't know how to get Mike Morgan's steam shovel out. And then the boy speaks up and says, if you can't get this, if you can use this steam shovel as the new heater, and Mike Morgan can be the new janitor. I like this book because the pictures make you want to read it again and again. I like to read because it helps you pass the time when there's nothing to do.
This book is called Private, and it's by Kate Bryan.
It's about a girl who originally was like going to a public school. She was really smart and athletic, so she got a scholarship to this like private prep school, which is really like prestigious. And the book is basically about her life there and all the drama that follows her. Uh-huh. It's filled with twists and turns that will keep you interested the whole time.
And it just, like, there's just a lot of drama that happens, and she meets a lot of interesting people that, I guess, I don't know, it just keeps you thinking, and
maybe she trusts them all too easily.
Or a little too much.
Yeah. And it's a series, it's still continuing.
There are 13 books so far, and the 14th will come out soon. And there's actually also a spinoff from one of the characters that ends up leaving the books. There's a whole new series based on her life. I like reading because it's better than watching TV. Like, it makes you smarter, helps your vocabulary, and it's fun.
If you would like to be a book reviewer, just let your children's librarian know to include you on the list for the next recording, which will take place after Christmas. I would like to thank you for visiting our first Reading Cafe post. Please join us next week for more book reviews and fun events. See you then!